Hi, this is Scott Erickson with Dusty Biesecker with DTG. Welcome to our overview, installation, and setup video on the new HP Latex 110 printer. Now, for those of you not familiar with DTG, we're a systems integrator in computer graphics, specializing in input, printer, output, and color management solutions. We're based in Tampa, Florida, but we also have warehouses all over the country that allow us to ship to our customers pretty much one day via ground service. What we're going to do today is cover the new HP Latex 110 printer. Some of the differences between the 110 and the 310 is basically the 110 comes with smaller ink tanks, 400 milliliter cartridges versus 775. What that means and equates to is basically around a 36% higher ink per milliliter cost. When you factor in the print heads and the maintenance tanks, it comes down to about 28% in terms of your ROI on the printer and your cost per print. Another difference with the printer is basically the 110 has a cutter groove as well. So different from the 310, it actually allows you to insert a blade and cut your prints off. The 310 does not have that. The 110 ships with generic profiles. You can update and upgrade those and actually use our DTG profiles as well as HP standard profiles. The 110 does not ship with inks, so when you're placing your order for your 110, make sure that you talk to your DTG rep about a set of inks as well. Another difference is the 110 does not have four color economy mode, so you can only print using all six color inks. So let's talk about what we're going to do with the this video. We're basically going to talk about site prep, making sure that your area where you're going to set up the printer is ready to receive and set up and install and use the printer. We're going to unbox the printer, show you how to do that. We're going to actually assemble it, put it together, as well as some basic use like loading ink and paper. And finally, we're going to go over installing the software as well as using the software to make a quick print. Okay, what we'll do at this point is go ahead and get ready to unbox the printer. As you can see, this thing is big. Dusty and I will go ahead and start breaking down the box, cutting off the packing material so that we can show you how to unbox the printer. All right, so when we talk about site prep, two considerations: receiving the actual printer in the box and on the crate. Again, if you haven't already purchased the printer, talk to your DTG rep. More than likely you're going to need and request a lift gate on the truck so we can get it off the truck for you. At that point, whether it's in your driveway or in your parking lot, that's a point where you need either a pallet jack or you need some help moving that printer. Now, some of our customers will actually assemble the printer right where it's unloaded off the truck, so that isn't an option for you. The other thing to consider basically is where the printer is going to sit once it's assembled in your office or in your room. Okay, so with unloading or unboxing the printer and assembling it, we need about 3 feet on the back side and about 5-6 feet on the front side. Once we get it assembled inside, we need to think about electrical. We can push the printer right up against the wall once everything is installed, so we don't need to get to the back of it during operation, which is one of the nice features. But electrical is a big consideration. This is a 220 or 200 to 240 volt outlet. We need two of those outlets, one rated for 13 amp, one for 3 amp, and this is the actual plug connection. I would encourage you to refer to the actual documentation or talk to DTG specifically about your plug configuration and your electrical requirements. The other things to consider are obviously your computer. The RIP software that comes with the printer is a basic version of Flexi, which is a wizard-based piece of software. Again, a little bit different than the 310. It does allow you to do more advanced things, but out of the box, it's a basic configuration, very easy to use. So a PC workstation is what you need to drive this printer, not a Macintosh. Ethernet connectivity, and anything else I'm forgetting? Is that pretty much it, Dusty?
That's pretty much it.
Okay. So what we'll do now at this point is we'll go ahead and unbox the printer. What we've done here is we've removed the packing tape, scored the top of the box, and what we're going to do is if we lift this all the way out, immediately inside on the top is the actual setup guide. So HP has included right here on the top of the box, a big fold out with step-by-step instructions on how to assemble this printer. Now obviously you can refer to this video as well, but this is really nice if you want to stop, read, and then come back to the video to help you install it. Okay, now that we've got the setup guide out, what we'll do is we'll go ahead and lift the outer box over the printer. It can come straight up and off the printer. So once over, we'll just push it forward, get this out of the way a little bit, and now you can see the contents of the inner box. We've got stand, accessories, parts, and then the printer itself down here. What we'll do is we'll go ahead and unbox the printer stand parts and proceed on to show you how to assemble that. Okay, so this is the box broken down. We've got four boxes that were on top of the main printer box. You've basically got the load tray for roll paper, the stand components, power, and the print heads, as well as some accessories for the stand as well. So what we'll do at this point, we'll start assembling the stand so we can get the printer on the stand. Okay, so now what you're looking at is basically the stand contents. We've got the cross brace, the legs, the wheels, the side panels. Now this is marked left and right. So right now, basically, I'm on the right, Dusty's on the left. We've also got these yellow pegs. So what we're going to do is we're basically going to flip this so the yellow pegs are down. And again, it's marked right and left. The side legs are also marked right and left as well. So what we're going to do is slide this out and discard it, remove the packing material, and Dusty's going to go ahead and install the left leg onto the cross brace. There's basically four pins that go into these holes on the cross brace, and it'll kind of fit. You'll feel it kind of snap into place. And then what he's going to do is go ahead and take four screws and attach that leg to the cross brace. What we'll do is we'll go ahead and do that side, I'll do this side, and then we'll catch up with you later. All right, next we're going to take the foot bar, and we're going to go ahead and insert that. We're going to take the side with the tab, which is goes into the right side. We're going to put that side in first into the notch. Dusty's going to put his end down, and then there's two screw holes here, two screw holes there. We'll go ahead and screw that in from the outside of the leg and continue on. Okay, now we're going to go ahead and take the feet with the casters on it and go ahead and mount it to the printer stand. We're going to make sure we do not remove this spongy material, which is an anti-slip material, because it's going to come in handy in a little bit when we go to flip the printer on it. So we've got two pins on the top. When we line up the leg to fit in those two pins, the four screw holes that we're going to use to mount the screw, the foot to the stand are going to line up. If we had done it this way, it wouldn't line up. So if you know, you can see and insert the four screws, you're good to go. So we'll do it here, here, and catch you later.
Okay, so the next step in the process is we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna flip the stand over. And we're gonna put two screws in the cross beam on both sides. Okay, so once the stand is flipped, we're gonna put the side covers on and we're gonna put two screws in the top loosely, and then we're going to grab the sides and slide those into position, and then we'll go ahead and tighten it up with the rest of the screws. Okay, so once we got the stand together, we're ready to position the printer to prepare to put it on the stand. So the first step we're going to do is we're going to take off these two pieces here. We're going to make sure that we save these. We're going to need these later. Okay, the next step is we're going to pop the straps in the front to get the cardboard to release.
We're also going to do it in the back.
And then what we're going to do is we're going to slide the printer forward off of the pallet. Okay, now there's two bags underneath here that help in sliding. And once we have it down to a 90 degree, we're going to go ahead and we're going to flip the printer up back onto the pallet.
And just to note that we're flipping this forward where the sides of the desiccant bags are. So make sure you don't flip it the other way where the desiccant bags are not. So towards the ground where the sides of the desiccant or the desiccant bags are. So now we're ready to attach the stand to the printer. What we're going to do is go ahead and remove these pieces from the packing material. We're going to cut away the plastic, get it completely out of the way, and we're going to attach the stand to the printer. Now the instructions say attach the right side to the side with the hole. Well, there's actually three holes on the right side and two holes on the left side. So the one that's got the three sides is the right. It's actually also marked on the styrofoam as well. So as long as you keep that, refer to that, you'll be good to go. So we'll go ahead and grab the stand, flip it over. And then attach it. We're in the notch. We got one screw over here, two screws over there. We'll screw those down and get ready to rotate the printer. All right, so now we're ready to rotate the printer so that we can get it off the crate and ready to roll into our room. So what we've done is we've taken those pieces of styrofoam that we put aside earlier. We've put them on the front with a U shape. What we're going to do first is we're going to go ahead and rotate the printer down onto those styrofoam pieces. So Dusty's going to be over there. Now, one real quick point. We do recommend four people at this point. We're going to go ahead and do it with two because Dusty's so strong over there, but we do recommend you do this with four people. All right, so we'll go ahead and rotate it. And you'll notice we've got the anti-slip rubber still on the foot down toward the bottom, touching the ground. Next, we're going to go behind the printer, and we're going to lift up and towards the front, and we're good to go. Now that we've got the printer upright, we're going to go ahead and remove all the packing material. We're also going to remove the rubber anti-slip stuff from the wheels. And what we'll do is show you actually how to remove the packing tape from the maintenance tank and the print head in a few minutes. So now we'll go ahead and remove the internal packing material, which is some tape and some cardboard. We'll go ahead and open up the cover, pull the tape off, and then we'll remove the cardboard from inside. We're going to open up the maintenance tank cover and then remove this tape and then remove the styrofoam from inside that locks the print head down. Next, we're going to go ahead and install the loading table support bracket. We'll do the right first. This is the loading table. The right basically attaches to the right leg with two screws. So if I kind of feel flush, it'll snap in because there's a pin there. I'm going to go ahead and insert these two screws and get that locked down. Next, we'll take the tube that came with the loading table. We'll put the left end into the left bracket. Then I'm going to take the right end, go ahead and support, put it into the hole on the right bracket. And Dusty's going to mount that on the left side, take two screws, and we'll mount it to the printer stand. Now we're ready to go ahead and attach the loading table to the brackets. Dusty will put his left end in first. Kind of hold it up vertical like this. I'll put my right end in.
So once the tray assembly is in place, you need to make sure that you ground out the printer with the switch right here. So it basically just goes right up underneath. Okay, so we went ahead and we turned the printer around, and we're going to finish up the installation with the cross beams in the back. So we're going to put a screw down the bottom side there. And then we're going to go ahead and attach it like a diagonal X pattern to the front.
With the white label facing you.
Okay, so once the first side is down, we're going to basically put label to label. We're going to flip it over and attach the next side.
All right, so now we're ready to put the printer in place. We're go ahead and grab the power cables. Again, there are two. There's one for the printer, one for the curing. They are interchangeable. They're not fixed to either plug. We'll go ahead and plug those into the back of the printer. One real quick note is the length of these cables, they're 8 feet. So when you're doing your site preparation, again, make sure that your printer can sit within about 8 feet of your plugs, your electrical connections. Once we get these plugged in, we'll go ahead and power on the printer from the back main power switch. There is a power switch on the front as well, but this is the main switch for the electric. All right, so the printer is powered up. You can see we've unboxed the print heads as well as the ink cartridges. Once it does fire up and initialize, the front panel will ask us to select a language. We're going to go ahead and do that. And it asks us to say yes to confirm English. And it also gives us a little tip to go ahead and configure the RIP later and some a URL for support information as well. So we'll just go ahead and then click I have read and understood the instructions, and we'll click OK. This is going to initialize the ink system, and then it's going to ask us to go ahead and insert the ink cartridges.
Okay, so now the printer is asking us for ink. So basically we want to look at the cartridge and make sure we can read the word HP level. We pull off the cartridge, drop in the ink, and push it in. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and we're going to install the last ink cartridge in. And you want to make sure you hear the ding.
All right, so also on the front panel, as well as the ding, you've got a indicator showing you that Dusty successfully installed all the cartridges. So now we can go ahead and hit OK on the front panel. It's checking them to make sure they're genuine HP Latex ink cartridges, and then we'll continue on from here.
Okay, so now that the system has ink, it's going to check to make sure that the ink is going through. So we're going to open up the panel, as instructed on the panel, and we're going to open up the reservoir. And basically we're going to check in here to make sure that there's ink inside these little mini print heads. These are temporary print heads to check that there's ink in there. It's very important at this step to make sure there's ink in there. The printer is asking if there's ink in there or not. If there's not, make sure you say no ink. If there is ink, then tell it ink. Okay, so after you agree that there's ink inside the temporary printheads, you close the cover, then you close the main cover, and then now it's asking for the maintenance cartridge. So it's recommending that you use gloves. However, this is a new install, so it should be fine. So we're saying continue. And now it's asking us to open the door. And now we're going to insert our cartridge. Basically, you're just going to push until it grabs. And shut the lid, and we're ready to go. Okay, so once it accepts the maintenance cartridge, it's asking us to open the window. And it's going to ask us to remove the temporary print heads. So we're going to go ahead and do that.
So Dusty's using a little bit of force. He's grabbing the top of the little caps, the clear caps with the ink in it, and just pulling straight up out of the printer.
Okay, so once the temporary printheads are removed, it's asking us to install the permanent printheads. So basically, we're going to remove the orange caps on the top and the bottom, and we're going to drop the printheads into position.
And show the contacts on there as well?
Yeah, on the back. Now you should hear a beep letting you know that the printhead's installed correctly, and it should show you in the panel as well. So we're just going to repeat the process. Okay, so once the last printhead's installed, we're going to go ahead and we're going to close the lid. There's a blue latch on here that you have to actually clip down. And then you go ahead and shut the cover, and the system will charge up.
So once the printer has finished priming those print heads that we just put in, which takes about 10 or 15 minutes, the front panel goes ahead and instructs us to load paper roll or paper media so that we can go ahead and align the print heads. Now, to load paper in the HP printer, what we're going to do is we'll first take the spindle out of the printer. There's a little blue lever over here on the right. I need to flip that up. That way it'll release the spindle so that I can get to it. So you've got a right edge and a left edge. The right edge is fixed. We can't move or slide that. But the left edge is actually adjustable. So I can use the little lever here to unlock it. So if I've got a 42-inch roll or 36-inch roll, I can slide to adjust that. Now it also includes 2- and 3-inch spindle adapters. So basically I can, if I've got a 2-inch core roll of media, I can just squeeze the tabs All right, and then basically pop that on and off really easily. Same thing on the bottom. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and load this roll to do the printhead alignment. I do want to use a higher quality roll to do this printhead alignment. I don't necessarily really want to do this on cheap banner material because I want the printhead alignment to be accurate. Also important to note, the printer does not come with media. So definitely contact DTG and we can set you up with a roll of media or a couple of rolls. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and we picked up the roll, put it on the loading table, which is a nice feature of the HP. What we're doing is we're basically winding over the top of the roll as you're seeing it like this up into the printer. All right, so at this point, I can go ahead and insert the spindle into the right edge. And then Dusty can go ahead and take that left one, put it on the left. Okay, we're gonna push all the way over to the right. There's actually two blue markers here, so we're gonna use the far right marker always. We're always gonna use that marker. All right, so at this point, the printer is actually instructing me to do this, so I'm gonna push the load roll button, all right? And it's basically asking me for the load configuration. So it's asking about SKU acceptance and tolerations and things like that. I don't really need to worry about that right now. You can push show instructions for some help with that. So I'm just gonna click continue, and it's telling me to feed the paper into the printer at this point. So now we'll go ahead and load the paper. We're gonna use the loading tray to help us put the roll into the printer. So we'll just lift that up all the way in. We'll make sure that the right and the left end are fully in. So we just push and make sure they're in. And they are. So next, we're gonna feed the actual paper up into the printer. So if you look up, once you get down here, there's a black bar that spins. We wanna take our paper and actually go over the black bar and then up into the printer. So once we do that, we feed it all the way up, the printer will ding and actually grab the media for us. All right, once it grabs the media, it's feeding it into the printer at this point. So once the printer has fed the media in, on the front panel, it's asking me what type of media I've got in it. So in this case, we've got self-adhesive vinyl. So I'm gonna go ahead and select that, and I'm gonna take a sub-selection of that because it's got two choices. I'm gonna say generic self-adhesive vinyl, not the backlit version. So once I check that, the printer's gonna initialize and continue on with loading the paper. So it's checking wind direction so that it can auto-feed it. So once it feeds it, it's actually checking SKU at that point. So it's actually warning me, hey, this is a little bit off. What do you wanna do? Do you wanna continue with it a little bit off? Or would you like to retry? So what we're gonna do is I wanna get it a little bit straighter than it is. So I'm gonna hit retry. All right, so it's checking the substrate again. So it's feeding it back and forth. And then it'll basically allow me to manually adjust that. So at this point, I'm gonna lift this lever, which lifts up the pinch rollers on the printer. So it allows me to grab the media and kind of straighten it out and line it up. All right, and it's telling me on the front panel, align to the spindle edge, all right, on the black edge of the roll holder. So if I pull that and line that right edge up where the right edge of the paper is on the roll, I can straighten it better. So once I do that, I'm gonna go ahead and close the lever. It's gonna check it again, and we should be good to go. So the media loaded successfully, and the printer automatically went into the printhead alignment. And what the printhead alignment is doing is basically aligning the colors, aligning bidirectional, so that we get the best possible quality when we start printing. So after the printhead alignment finishes, the screen comes up and asks us to enable the web interface printer. So what we're gonna do is go ahead and connect an Ethernet cable to our network. This is plugged into our router. The connection is on the back. You can just plug that right in. And when we'll hit continue and basically hit check to see if it can auto-configure itself. If it can't auto-configure itself, you can give us a call. We can kind of walk you through the router settings to get that connected. What this allows you to do is basically get online with the printer. And that allows you to download media substrates right from HP.com. It also allows you to download firmware updates, which basically are the brains to the printer that increases, you know, features, reliability, fixes bugs, things like that. So it's a really nice feature to go ahead and connect that to the web.
Okay, so when you want to unload the media, basically what you're going to do is you're going to go to the substrate button, and you're going to basically say unload. And now the printer will wind the media out and allow you to take the roll off and change the roll. A really important accessory that comes with the Latex series printers, the 110 especially, are the edge clips. And we want to talk about how to put these in there. So basically to install these, all you do is lift up the cover. And I'm going to hand these to Scott over here to this side. And you're going to put them in always over to the left-hand side of the machine. And you're going to slide it in, and then it slides along the rail. So what these do is they sit underneath the media to keep the media flat to prevent head strikes.
So these also have white lines. So when they're sliding over the edge of the media, you can line up the white line with the edge of the media on both the left and the right side. And so these just slide back and forth to whatever the width of the roll of the media that you have is. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and install the FlexiPrint software. Now, it's important to note that the printer did not come with a disc to install the software. There was a white card attached to the printer and the tape that had the FlexiPrint label. And we removed that, and inside that is a smaller card with a web address to go to and your registration or activation code. So what we'll do is we'll just go to a web browser and we'll type in www.saicloud.com. It will bring us to this page. Then we're going to type in our activation code that is on that card. When I click the activate button, once I've typed in that code, it's going to bring us to a screen which is basically going to ask us either to log in or to create a new account. If it's the first time you've used FlexiPrint software, we'll just go ahead and register with our email address and information. Once you register, you will get an email from SAI that will instruct you where to download the software and how to continue on. Okay, so I've got my email link and I downloaded the installation starter. So I'll just go to my downloads folder on my computer. I'll double click the executable for the download for the FlexiPrint software, and that will start the installation. So this will actually download the full program to my hard drive. So once this finishes, we'll go ahead and continue on with the installation. So after it downloads, it automatically extracts the installer and asks to begin the installation process. So we'll click yes and start the install of the FlexiPrint software. So basically just okay through here like any other installation wizard, next through, and we'll continue on. Accept the terms. We'll install the dongle driver just in case in the future you ever get a dongle. And then continue through the installation process. So once the installer finishes, it will automatically launch this window where we can put our activation code from our little card that came with the printer. So we'll go ahead and enter that activation code and click Next. It will then start communicating with the SAI website in order to verify and download the license for our serial number or activation code. So once it goes out and verifies your activation code, you'll get this screen showing licensing successful. You may need to remove the dashes in some cases. So if you try it with the dashes and it doesn't work, then try it without dashes and that should do the trick. Then we're just going to click Finish. Okay, so what we'll do now, once it's installed, we're going to go ahead and launch the FlexiPrint HP Basic 110 Edition. Since this is the first time we've launched the software, we're going to go ahead and set up the printer, and by default, it will automatically select your HP 110 printer. So then we'll just click Next. It will then ask us to specify the IP address for the printer. Now the IP address can be entered manually on the front panel of the HP Latex printer. And
either your network will automatically get an address or you can specify that manually. So we specified it manually on the front panel. We're going to go ahead and enter that now. By default, the port should be 9100, so don't change that. We'll click OK. We can basically hit the test button to make sure it's communicating with that IP address. And actually, let me type 110 because it's 110. We'll hit the test button to see if it's communicating. And it says success, so we are communicating. Now I can just click finish. So now it's automatically going out to the printer and waking it up. And it's actually reading the media library from the printer. So after that, it automatically launches the print wizard. At this point, we could open up a file by clicking this and adding the file, or we can just exit and then enter the wizard manually through here, through this button right here. So let's see how to use the wizard. So we'll click the wizard icon, then click the folder to add our printer, so we can double click or just single click, then hit add. Then we'll hit next. We'll select our printer. We only have one in this case, so we'll let it default. Next, we want to go ahead and select the media that matches the media type in the printer. So we happen to have a Oracle media in the printer. It is automatically querying the printer to match that of the width that's loaded in it. So then we'll just click next. Then we can specify our high quality or standard quality. All right, so we'll select high quality in this case. Then hit next. Then it'll ask us to choose an output profile. By default, the wizard is just going to pick the appropriate profile, so you don't even have to set that. So we'll click next. And then it's asking how many copies we want. So if I said 3, the software is intelligent and will automatically rotate and basically step that across the width of my paper. At this point, if I want to change the color for my job, I can select yes. If I don't, I can select no. But let's go ahead and see how you can change the color. So I'll click next. It'll automatically launch a little color, easy color wizard, and allow me to make more magenta or more green or yellow and so on. I'm going to leave it set, so we'll just click OK. So now if my job is ready to print, I'm just going to click the print icon. And then basically that sends it to the job queue, which will populate right here and then get ready to print and send to the printer.
So that completes the setup of the HP Latex 110 printer. We hope you found that informative. One of the tips we wanted to talk about is the printer comes with a 6-month warranty. If you want to double that, extend it another 6 months to a full year, you can do that in 5 easy steps. Real important, just basically go online, enter your serial number and your information, take a simple online training class for the Latex 110 printer, and then basically confirm the email and register the printer. And that will get you the extra 6 months for a total of 1 year warranty. Also, just wanted to talk about DTG a little bit more. Definitely you can contact us for technical support, any questions that you have on your HP Latex 110 printer. We also offer custom ICC profiles and media setups that we can email you, and you can upload right into the printer. So it gives you a lot more variety of medias that you can print on. Dusty Biesecker is a great resource here at DTG. Been in the industry, the sign industry, for 15 years, 20 years. Does repair, sales, tech support. So definitely, if you have any questions, you can call Dusty, myself, or any other tech support at DTG. You can visit us online at www.dtgweb.com or give us a ring at 800-681-0024. Thanks a lot.